and more appropriately than ever, administering an industry-recognized credential assessment. And next year, we are even more excited to offer an education preparation course. This course will teach our students to be the teachers of the future. The concept is to grow our own. Upon completion at Manning, students will continue their studies at Norman Casey to earn a bachelor's in education. Manning students will continue their bachelor's at Norman Casey to get that bachelor's in education, and then they will come back to KCPS to teach. It doesn't get any better than that. Our students are transitioning to careers through focused education. This year, in addition to our continued partnership with Alta Vista Charter School, we partnered with a school in another district. Yes, Raytown South had one of their students complete our EMT program at Manning. This demonstrates that Manning is growing and developing relationships with other school districts. The education and training our students receive at Manning are like no other. Our goal is to prepare our students for their future by providing them with the opportunity to learn a skill. However, we don't want this to be their last stop. When our students leave us, they will be equipped with the skills to pursue employment and hopefully get more on-the-job training, as well as be prepared to enter a post-secondary degree program. Either way, they will be ready for whatever path they choose to follow. Thank you for being with us this evening to cheer our students on to the next stage of their lives. And again, welcome. Welcome to Manning's 2017 graduation and certification program. Thank you. Our director of CTE for the Tennessee Public Schools, she will introduce our platform guest.
Thank you, Angela. My name is John Brothers, as it's already said, and I'm the director of Career and Technical Education for Tennessee Public Schools. I am with this ready to welcome to you all. I'm so glad that you all are here. It is my pleasure to welcome our special platform guest. When I call your name, will you please stand? Ms. Angela Brady, Assistant Director of Career Tech.
Right now, I have the opportunity to enter the body shop industry. I might want to obtain my work work in the field just for the summer to help earn money, to help post-secondary goals, or I'll make sure that as a career. Either way, this course has given me options. I'm proud of myself for completing loan modules, quizzes, a writing test, and post-test. That was the most challenging. I'm also grateful for the opportunity to be able to bring my heart into the project for my classmates and mine. Even though it was a long learning process, we pulled through and found some patience to get it done. But I know, I can say it was all worth it in the end. To my auto position instructor, Dean Gales. Also, I would like to thank the therapy, man. Since day one, he taught me a lot about life, how to be a man I'm going to be, and he taught me to trade out of religion. Sometimes I wish I had another year to better my skills as an individual, because I know I still have a lot to learn. I also want to thank all my classmates. They helped me with this project this year, which was my car, from start to finish. I know it was a difficult process at times, but I want to thank you all for not giving up when it got frustrated, providing me the help I need when I needed it. And hopefully, I was helpful to you all as well. I would also like to thank everyone here at Manning Career Technical Center, because if it wasn't for this program and me getting out at 11 o'clock every day, I'd probably be at home chilling or at work trying to increase my hours so I'm patient a little bit. Instead, I choose to be in the trade program, trying to find a skill and a trade that I'm pretty good at and that I can use to provide for myself and for my family in the future. Manning Tech is a great and beneficial educational center provided by the Kansas City Public School District. I say this because, for example, the students who have earned most of their credits to graduate, then Manning Tech is the perfect spot. In addition to a high school diploma, this program gives students the opportunity to learn a trade they can use for a lifetime. In other words, learning something and becoming good at it can keep us financially stable and happy with life. Manning Tech gives us an early learning experience and skills of trade that once we pass, gives us a certificate of completion. This certificate of completion is something we will show to a potential employer to get the job. Having this paper will allow a student to earn more than minimum wage. That's why this program is very helpful to students who attend high school and community public schools. My plans after I leave here is to continue my education at Texas Southern University. I plan to major in business marketing to learn everything I need to know about my major so that I can be a productive citizen of our country and our world. I challenge all of my fellow many of classmates to make your plans now. Be in college or further training in your field, just make sure you plan to make a difference in your life and in this world. Thank you.
She has more than 38 years of experience in healthcare leadership.
She spent 11 years at the University of Colorado Hospital and Health Sciences Center and 15 years at the University of Kansas Hospital. She is a fellow of the American College of Healthcare Executives and has repeatedly won that organization's Regents Award for Distinguished Service and Professional Development. Mrs. Sanders Hall is also the President-elect of the Kansas City Association of Healthcare Executives. Mrs. Sanders Hall has received numerous honors and awards, which are very impressive, but too many to mention. However, what is worth mentioning is that she is a fighter. Her life should be an inspiration to all of us. It is my honor to present to you our guest speaker for this evening, KCPS alumni, Mrs. Patricia Sanders Hall. Please join me in welcoming.
Graduates, you are here
In this time of your lives, you will face challenges and you will need to make split-second decisions on how to respond when something difficult, unfair, or unkind happens to you. None of us gets through life without some struggles and disappointments along the way. But you will have the greatest success if you choose not to dwell on the times you get knocked down, but to focus on the times you got back up again. I will always remember something my father told me. You may be right, but if you act badly, you will never win. You see, acting badly covers up your good intentions. Acting badly thwarts your righteous cause, and acting badly blocks your path to justice. Graduates, you have acted very well by staying in school. You have acted well by studying hard. You have acted well in graduating and setting your career path. By choosing the high road and doing your best, you have created the strongest comeback response to the naysayers. Your success today and the future is the best opportunity to shut down those who try to stop you. So I say again, take the high road. Take the high road when great words come your way to devalue you. Smile and resist the temptation of a momentary victory of sinking to the low level of your detractors. Take the high road of a lasting victory of a successful career that will prove those mean words and those negative statistics are just plain wrong about you. Take the high road and get the last laugh, because you will be the better person. When a well-intentioned person said to me long ago that I had limited chances to achieve the big dreams I was expressing, that really hurt. And it knocked me down a few pegs. But I decided I was going to let that person's short-sightedness cloud my destiny. So I got back up and I pushed forward. And that's what you need to do in planning out your life. Oh yes, seek wise counsel. But at the end of the day, search your own heart and follow your passion. I went through times when everywhere I turned, someone was trying to block my way. And I could have allowed myself to become discouraged or to quit. I could have felt bad and given up, but I kept going until I became the first Black woman to become the clinical vice president at the University of Kansas.
Know deep down in your spirit
that you have the intrinsic and undeniable value created inside of you, just for being you. Let me close the poem I wrote years ago for another graduating class called The Greatness in You. It's time to get ready, don't be late. Reach for tomorrow's goals today. Go on, get going, don't hesitate. Don't let this chance slip away. Today is the day, and this is the hour, to strive for the future you seek. You have the strength and you have the power to make a climb to the highest peak. The world is waiting out there for you, and there are good things or bad for you to choose. It's your decision to do what you do. You're the one who must walk in your shoes. It can be a hard struggle, but worth the fight to say no when negative pressures say yes. But you'll know in your heart that you were right as you keep passing all of life's tests. Yes, this is the time. The moment is now. Get started and you will go far. Then you'll hear no pause and you can take your bow for being the true winner you are. There's a greatness in you, seeking to be. Don't let anything stand in your way. Unlock your dreams. You hold the key. Reach for tomorrow's goals today. Congratulations, man, on your career.
schools across the region and state compete, and I'm proud to announce that under the leadership of Honorable Collision Instructor Mr. Dean Gale, Jose plays second in the region and Tyler plays third. Congratulations.
Dr. Dale, on behalf of the administration,
Do you accept our graduating class of leaders in 2017 from the Career Center and the Career Technical Education Program?
I do.
Thank you. Thank you. Dequan Rollins. Ramirez. Cecilia Gomez. Joaquin Medina.
Students, this is only your first day. you for making this such a fun and memorable year. I promise you'll never